Our vision was to have a really strong impact upon a younger group of men so that we could open up the stories and offer ways for change and to address the broader question of men's violence towards women. One of the key areas that I worked in was domestic violence, and extending from that, the need to provide different forms of education for young men as they were growing up and coming through school, so that young men can see alternative ways of being men and masculinity. If we understand those messages, those stories, we can change the story.
I feel like this is something that's really needed in Australia as a whole, because we know that violence against women is such a big issue at the moment, and working with young men is so important, getting them to take ownership on this. And it's not a one and done program. It's like talking about what's deeper than that, and what it means to be a real man is being a good person, essentially.
I've become more open-minded to topics we talk about, like gender and violence, and I've just understood both points of view and taken that to form my own.
Definitely about violence, the one hit can really make a huge difference. And one fight can easily end a life.
One of the topics was treating women with respect and with trust, and we looked at domestic violence statistics, and that changed the perspective of a lot of the guys' views on how they should treat their partner or future partner. We want to bring down those statistics down as much as we can.
We discuss gender roles in society, behaviour that occurs around gender, maybe discrimination, and really around that toxic masculinity. Some people have very set ideas of what a man should be and what a woman should be for that matter. We discussed how that's not necessarily the case.
So a lot of it was about gender and gender equality and how we treat people, and everyone being there together in the one room, sharing their perspective of the topic, changed how they view that thing.
Society has a lot of norms and ideals about what a man is. But to me, a man is standing up for what you believe in, standing up for what's right, taking the leap forward to call out behaviour, to make yourself happy and others happy.
What makes you a real man is respect and not judging people, you know, treating women, whoever, correctly, and being a role model and not being a bad influence. Like, you can have your fun, but at the same time, you've got to be respectful.
Growing up for me, it was probably a little bit stuck to those sort of stereotypes. I'm glad we've come a bit of a way since then, and I've certainly learned a lot since then as well. Being a man is about being your unique self. You know, the more I've learned about gender, the more that gender doesn't really matter to me.
Everyone kind of has their part to play in improving that world where everyone is equal. Everyone is important in that sense of, like, everyone can do stuff to improve the lives of others, both known and unknown to us.
The safe space, having that space to share different topics that aren't often talked about and to hear each other's stories. It broke down some of the judgment that may have existed between the groups to kind of go, you're actually a person and I've heard your story and I can respect that.
Talking about the way they perceive things and their place as part of relationships. I think getting them to be more in touch with their roles within relationships and then expressing those thoughts to others that they're in relationships with can only benefit what they're involved in.
Intergenerational issues, it's like a flow-on effect. So my dad does it with his dad, I do it with my dad, my son will do it with me. And that's one of the things that I'd like to try and change to hopefully become a lot closer of a family and be more connected and more stable.
With their discussions and their sharing of stories, I did see empathy. I saw aha moments, treating others with respect when they left that room, and not being a bystander all the time.
Society still has a lot of divide, I feel, in how men and women are treated. Thinking about other people's viewpoints or experiences, I think, was one of the most valuable aspects of the program. So hearing that really opened my eyes to what goes on, but also other areas, different work situations, different situations at school. So I think that was one of the really key takeaways for me.
They've enjoyed the chance to express themselves and to be able to talk about it in an area that's not normally available to them.
Like, I reflected on kind of the social norms have been placed on myself and other men around me, males in my life, in my family. It's given me an outlook to the behaviours I do now and what I can change and what I'm doing right. So I think it will help change perspective of not only yourself but others, and how can we help them and what do they need to be supported.
We discussed important topics that often aren't talked about, something we should be really grateful that we had the opportunity. All schools should sort of follow in this open group discussion thing.
The ability to not just hear other people's stories and perspectives, but that empathy to kind of journey that with them. I think we lack a lot of empathy in our society, and if that's the one thing we can teach our young people, that's pretty good.
In the group and out of the group, they start talking about how there's these things that these parents have passed down that they don't want to listen to because they know that it's not appropriate and stuff like that. They just got to talk to everyone else and realise they don't have to follow these things just because their parents think it's normal.
I mean, the ultimate vision is to end men's violence towards each other and to end men's violence towards women and children. And in a bigger picture, to reduce the kind of violence that we see in our media and our workplaces and our organisations and our sporting clubs.
Awareness, definitely. Awareness and the fact that we have that power to change that. That is the core message that I remembered and are trying to remember and trying to make the world a better place.
I could reflect what we discussed about in the lessons and I could apply that to my own life and see what I needed to change or what was working well.
Could have changed in preparing myself to be an adult, to grow up with the respect that I should have. So yeah.
Educating a person isn't just about the academic, it's a whole person, and we need schools to adapt these spaces so that they have space to talk about the things that matter beyond curriculum.
I guess just say thank you to everyone who come and helped us all with the Sammy D Foundation stuff. Yeah, it really did change me and it's done a lot for me.